Welcome to the second learning module on the role of geophysics in resource volume estimation and classification. In this module, I will provide you with an overview of how geophysic analysis can be used as part of an integrated analysis of the trap geometry, in particular related to unpenetrated fault blocks. We ask ourselves the question, can seismic analysis help us to determine reserves in unpenetrated fault blocks? Seismic attributes may indeed be used to establish reservoir and fluid continuity across faulted reservoirs in unpenetrated fault blocks, provided that all the following conditions are met. Within the drilled fault block, well logs, pressure and test data demonstrate a strong tie between the hydrocarbon-bearing reservoir and the seismic attributes, supported by synthetic seismic modeling. The fault throw is less than reservoir thickness over part of the hydrocarbon-bearing section across the fault, and the fault is not considered to be a major, potentially sealing fault. If all these conditions are met, the presence of hydrocarbons in the adjacent fault block related to the seismic flat spot or seismic amplitude anomaly may be judged sufficiently robust to qualify the associated hydrocarbon volumes in the undrilled compartment as reserves. However, it is important to establish that the seismic analysis results are consistent with results from the analysis of other available data sources, like for example pressure data or well test data. Let's have a look at the following Gulf of Mexico example to help guide our thinking. For this field, only block D has been penetrated by a well and demonstrated commercial flow rates. Final investment decision has been taken for the full field development for all four fault blocks. The blue fault separates the drilled block D from the other undrilled blocks. And the question is, can we book reserves in the undrilled fault blocks? In this case, synthetic modeling for well D has demonstrated a strong tie between the hydrocarbon-bearing reservoir and the seismic anomaly. The fault throw with block C is less than the reservoir thickness over part of the hydrocarbon-bearing section across the fault, and the fault is therefore not considered to be a major, potentially sealing fault. Furthermore, the seismic anomaly is spatially continuous and at the same depth across the fault. Therefore, the presence of hydrocarbons in block C may be judged sufficiently robust to qualify the hydrocarbon volumes in the undrilled compartment as reserves. However, the two blocks further up dip, blocks A and B, do show a larger fault throw, and the associated resource volumes are likely to be booked as contingent reserves. Let's introduce you to a logical workflow for the classification of resource volumes in unpenetrated blocks. In this workflow, we follow two major steps. Step 1, we must assess the fault juxtaposition. The first question we ask ourselves, is the fault throw less than the reservoir thickness over part of the hydrocarbon-bearing section across the fault? If this is not the case, the fault is considered a major, potentially sealing fault and only prospective resources can be assigned to the unpenetrated fault block. If this is the case, we need to do more analysis before we can properly make this assessment, and we must go to step 2, where we assess the likelihood of economically producible reservoir in the unpenetrated fault block. For this assessment, we will take many sources of data analysis into consideration as part of this integrated analysis, using all the available geoscience and engineering data. Sources that could be looked at could be, for example, pressure data, well test data, seismic inversion and attribute results, as well as production performance or reservoir simulation results. The results of these various analyses should be internally consistent and not contradict each other. Depending on the outcome of this integrated assessment for the likelihood of hydraulic communication across the fault, we may be able to assign either reserves or contingent resources to the unpenetrated fault block. Furthermore, it is important to map the fault in 3D with sufficient detail. This case study shows that detailed mapping of the fault provided evidence for reservoir continuity across the fault relay ramp, impacting the likelihood assessment of economically producing reservoir in the undrilled fault block, and hence the resource volume classification. In summary, seismic attributes may successfully be used to establish reservoir and fluid continuity across faulted reservoir in unpenetrated fault blocks. Under certain conditions, reserves may be assigned to the unpenetrated fault block, as discussed in this module. However, it is important that the seismic analysis results are consistent with results from and do not contradict the analysis of other available data sources, like for example pressure data or well test data. All available geoscience and engineering data should be used in the resource volume assessment for the unpenetrated fault block. We hope that you have enjoyed this module on the role of geophysics in resource volume estimation and classification for assessing the potential for reserves in unpenetrated fault blocks. In case you would require more detailed information, we would like to refer you to the September 2012 special issue of The Leading Edge, dedicated to the role of geophysics in reserves. Finally, the SEG Oil and Gas Reserves Committee would like to acknowledge all the companies that provided case study material for these learning modules. Thank you for your attention.